Okay, you're on.
Hi, I'm Asa Kirby from National Instruments, and this is the LabVIEW eBike. This was actually created by the University of Texas at Austin Senior Design Group. There's three separate mechanical engineers. They did it in 3 months. They started with basic information about LabVIEW. We gave them this compact Rio. This is actually an embedded computing system that's mounted on the bike, does all the control. The bike is entirely controlled by wire. So what we have is actually a throttle coming into the compact Rio. We have a speed sensor going into the compact Rio. And from there, it does a complex control algorithm to be able to control an electric motor, 450 watts, and a continuously variable transmission in the back here. Put all of that together, and you've got a rideable electric vehicle that is low cost, as well as made with primitive tools, and is more efficient with battery power than conventional electric vehicles are. All of this together is then transmitted back to a web page that actually runs over here on this laptop. Now note that the web page is being hosted on the compact Rio, we're just being able to see it here. If I turn on the system here, you can actually see it working. We have a nice little speed request is the white line, the green line is the current vehicle rear speed, and then the red line is the actual request being sent to the motor for it to actually output to a certain value. So we can ramp this up, get it up to all the way top speed. Notice, in fact, that the motor drops down because we've reached our top speed. Plus, the gear is providing us a gain factor on the motor in order to reduce the amount of power that we use.
You just hit a ludicrous speed.
That's right. Extra points in the class for anybody that gets that reference.
Okay.
Now, the students that actually designed this bike were able to actually simulate the control before they ever got on the bike. And they did a lot of simulations to come up with the actual gains for their control. However, they realized that when you are designing PID, you don't know it until you actually ride it. So when they actually rode it, they had to change some things. Let me give you an example of how the ride actually works.
All right, let's try it out. Okay.
So because it is a hybrid vehicle, we're actually able to still pedal it, and then we can actually engage the control. And the whole entire run that I just did was transmitted wirelessly back to the computer here. So you can actually see all the values that I attained and the requests that I was giving. And that is just another example of what you can do with LabVIEW and National Instruments hardware and software. Okay, so what we have here is actually the NI Wireless Pong demo. So everybody remembers the great 1980s game of Pong. We've just kind of brought it up into the year 2009. What we have here is actually a VI. So this is actually something entirely built in LabVIEW. You can see the basic structure there. And in fact, the game is quite simple. Looking at the block diagram, you can see it's just two separate loops. In the first loop, we actually have the main program control that's actually keeping track of the game here on the front panel. And this other loop is actually just keeping track of all those high scores that we've been entering along the way whenever somebody beats us terribly. So to actually see this in operation, we can actually start the VI.
Yeah.
And this is actually going to deploy, and you can see the game actually starting here. Now we can play Pong, select our players, and you actually get to see this board. This is actually all still in LabVIEW. We haven't left the environment of LabVIEW itself. Now what we're actually demonstrating here as far as hardware is concerned is the wireless sensor nodes. This is something brand new for LabVIEW, or for National Instruments. They're actually a battery-powered portable measurement system, so you're able actually to drop these nodes out in the field, battery powered. They'll read back voltages, digital values, they'll read back temperatures, a number of different things. This one in particular has a tilt sensor in the board itself that's keeping track of the position of the board, puts it back into the node, and then transmits it wirelessly through the Zigbee protocol back to the gateway over on the computer table over here. And then that's put back into the computer, and then the whole thing plays out here in a LabVIEW program. Stand on the board here, and then adjust your balance. It's a completely analog system here to be able to change the position of the paddle there on the table. And as I rotate here, I'm currently at the top, and the player that should be playing is missing terribly. But you can see that nice little blue paddle at the very top rotating back and forth.
Asa, what did we do here today?
We shifted paradigms. That's what we do best.
We changed a few worlds.
That's right. We changed worlds.
We inspired a few minds.
Yes, we impacted students.